What's going on, guys? It's Jimmy here, and welcome to our daily show where we discuss the fourth stimulus check update, the two new upcoming stimulus and infrastructure packages, as well as what is going on in the world today. President Biden just made an already controversial move in some new breaking news about giving money back to the Pentagon that was already earmarked for the border wall and will not be continuing the border wall construction. Let me know your thoughts on this, because this is already controversial. As you can see here, President Biden is returning billions of dollars that former President Donald Trump diverted for border wall construction to the Pentagon. The Biden administration plans to return Pentagon funds redirected by former President Donald Trump to build the wall on the U.S.-Mexico border and repair infrastructure and environmental damage that resulted from its construction, a White House administration official told Forbes. In a statement first reported by ABC News, the official said the Pentagon will be, quote, begin canceling all wall projects using the diverted funds, and, quote, take steps to return remaining unobligated military construction forms from their appropriated purposes. Those purposes include funding domestic counter-drug programs, overseas programs, constructing a school at a base in Kentucky, and purchasing trucks, generators, and other equipment for the National Guard, as well as ships and fighter jets, a Pentagon spokesman said. The development comes after President Joe Biden signed a proclamation shortly after taking office, halting the future redirection of money from the Pentagon budget to build the border wall, which was already ruled illegal by a federal court last June. The Department of Homeland Security did, although, announce plans to repair holes in flood levees at the Rio Grande Valley in Texas and from soil erosion in San Diego created by the border wall construction. Republican Senator Ted Cruz actually praised President Biden for the levee wall, saying, quote, I am pleased President Biden and the Department of Homeland Security are listening and now moving to shore up the levee wall system that has been unthoughtfully halted, calling the repairs necessary, crucial, and urgently needed. However, Republican Senator Rick Scott says, how can President Biden possibly justify stopping the border wall construction? And called on the administration to immediately explain President Biden's, quote, ridiculous order, how it is compliant with federal law, and the awful consequences it will have on the current crisis, unquote. Now, the strange thing is, even though President Biden is stopping border wall construction and taking money away from the border wall construction, the Biden administration, as you can see here, they promised to stop seizing border wall land, but his Department of Justice is still doing it. The administration is past a self-imposed 60-day deadline to review resources for the wall, and it's still taking land from some Texas families for it. So yeah, the border wall controversy, along with the immigration crisis that we're having literally at that exact border, is a very complicated issue. Let me know, do you think they should continue and finish up the border wall? President Donald Trump said, former President Donald Trump said in an interview a few weeks ago that he thought the border wall was around 90% completed and that it only needed about a month or so worth of work. And the money has already been spent to, you know, make the majority of the wall there, and just the holes need to be filled. This comes as the Biden administration just had a 15-year high of new illegal immigrants crossing the border. In fact, in March alone, there was 170,000 illegal immigrants that were caught on the U.S.-Mexico border, and that doesn't count the people that they didn't catch that slipped through the system or the wall that's not totally completed. So yeah, let me know your thoughts on this, as it's a very controversial issue, and the border crisis with immigrants coming over is just seems to be getting worse by the day, and I think it's gonna be a large problem for President Biden to tackle, and we'll have to see how it ends up. There are several different paths forward to passing the next two stimulus packages. The one physical infrastructure package known as the American Jobs Plan, which the White House says will create millions of jobs, and to pass the stimulus package, which is called the American Families Plan, which could have multiple different provisions. There's about 15 different stimulus items that they're considering putting in that package right now, including a fourth stimulus check. Democrats want monthly recurring stimulus checks, at least until the pandemic is over, of two different bills, $1,000 a month to $2,000 a month, are new proposals for a fourth stimulus check, recurring stimulus checks, as well as increasing the child tax credit all the way till the year 2025 or later, possibly making it permanent. The child tax credit is the bill that has already been passed in the third stimulus check package and will provide $3,000 to $3,600 per child, at least for the year 2021. That's already passed from the third stimulus check package. They're looking to increase it to go for at least four more years till 2025 or later. The IRS is setting up a monthly stimulus check program to pay this out in advance, starting in about 2 months from now in July, of $250 to $300 per month per child. They're also pushing for 2 years of free college and 2 years of free preschool in this next package, as well as possible Social Security increases. We have two different bill proposals for $200 per month Social Security increase and another one for $279 per month for an SSI increase that could possibly include SSDI, as well as multiple different Medicare reforms, which could include different services for free, which would include free hearing, vision, and dental coverage, free hearing aids, and also could lower the eligibility age for Medicare to age 60 or even age 55. Among other, among the Social Security improvements as well. And well, how to pay for them? There's several different ways. Here is outspoken Senator Elizabeth Warren on, she is one of the main, she's actually the co-author for the $2,000 per month stimulus checks, recurring stimulus checks. Here's her on how to pay for some of these programs.
But more broadly, when you talk about a fair tax system, what are you hoping to achieve in this instance?
Look, we need the revenues to be able to make investments in America going forward, in infrastructure, in child care, in the things that help us build a future. So how can we do that? Well, let's start with the fact that the 99% in America pay about 7.2% of their total wealth in taxes every year. But that top one-tenth of 1%, they're paying about 3.2%. We put a 2 cent wealth tax, 3 cents for people over a billion, and they're still paying less than the 99%. But that's part one, and we could raise about $3 trillion from that. Part two, those giant corporations that report more than $100 million in book profits, corporations like Amazon and Nike and FedEx that pay zero or little in taxes, a 7% across the board tax on their book profits. Something, by the way, an approach that President Biden is using. We could raise, from the way I do it, about $1.4 trillion. And the third is fair tax enforcement. Not just sending out letters to people who are making minimum wage, but actually hiring enough people at the IRS that we concentrate on the folks who are cheating at the top. The IRS commissioner says that we have a tax gap right now of about $1 trillion a year. Even if we only got a fraction of that, we could get about $1.8 trillion over 10. Right. Altogether, it's about $6 trillion that we could get just from those three changes in our tax laws. Right. That would more than pay for the infrastructure and have a couple of trillion left over.
Senator, do you think there's a framing issue around this? And the reason I ask is, depending on how you look at it, you could also say that a majority of the tax revenue that comes in more broadly, and we could talk about the percentages as you just did, but comes in from the 1%. But the reason I ask this is there are clearly lots of viewers of this network and others who've made an extraordinary amount of money who feel oftentimes that they're being attacked and oftentimes being attacked by you, as opposed to a sort of view of, look, you've had an enormous amount of success. You've worked very hard, hopefully, for it. Some of it may have been luck along the way, but you did it in America. Yeah. And what we're trying to do is figure out a way to contribute to the country and make it work. And oftentimes I hear from people on the other side of it who feel that they're being attacked. Whether that's fair or not, I'm curious how you just think about the framing piece of it.
Well, I think of it as you built a successful business. Good for you. We want to celebrate your success. But here's what I know for sure. Everyone who built a successful business here in America did it using a workforce that all of us paid to educate, did it getting their goods to market on roads and bridges that all of us helped to pay to build, did it protected by police and firefighters that all of us helped pay their salaries. And all we're saying is that when you make it big, and I mean really big, I mean the top one-tenth of 1%, pitch in a little more so everybody else gets a chance to make it in this country. That's all this is about.
So what do you think on that? Do you think that what she's saying there about raising taxes on the top one-tenth of 1% and also these corporations that make billions of dollars and don't pay any taxes, do you think that's fair, or do you think that's pushing it a little too far on successful people or corporations? Let me know your thoughts down below in the comments. The support is growing for a fourth stimulus check and the monthly recurring stimulus check bills that Democrats have produced themselves and are pressuring President Biden to include in this next stimulus package. There's about 15 different stimulus items that would benefit the average everyday American, such as a fourth stimulus check, monthly recurring stimulus checks, Social Security increases, Medicare increases, as well as child tax credit increases, which is basically monthly stimulus checks for children and their families. And the president is being pressured, and the support is continuing to grow for that every single day. Now, the Democrats are likely going to pass the stimulus package, the American Families Plan, completely on their own through the reconciliation process. The physical infrastructure package, they're looking for bipartisan support. Some people think that it could happen. Here is Democratic Senator Chris Coons.
All right, so square that answer you just gave me with what you said earlier today to a reporter saying there's real value in passing a smaller infrastructure bill if it's bipartisan. And I guess, do you view it as an either-or proposition, or do you view it as do as much stuff you can do in a bipartisan way and then save, and whatever you can't get done, then try reconciliation?
Absolutely the latter, Chuck. Just to be clear, I think there is value to bipartisanship, both domestically in the United States. As President Biden said several times last night, we need to show the American people that we can hear each other, we can negotiate, we can deliver answers to the problems facing their families. And there's also international value to bipartisanship, to showing our leading global competitors, China and Russia, who are running around the world saying that America, after that horrific riot in the Capitol on January 6th, that our democracy is in decline. But Chuck, there's also reasons we may need to pursue a bipartisan infrastructure bill first, is that there's members of both caucuses negotiating in good faith, willing to put pen to paper. We will work with senators like Senator Capito of West Virginia to do our absolute best to come up with a bold infrastructure package that will make that generational investment. I'll remind you, Chuck, we all drive on an interstate highway system that was built in the 50s and 60s. We've got airports and ports and roads and bridges and tunnels that are failing by any analysis or grade and makes us less competitive globally. I think we can and should find ways to pay for that, to build that, and to do that on a bipartisan basis, and then turn to the parts of the Biden plan and proposal that deal with things like climate change, resiliency, and investment in the caring economy that probably won't get Republican votes, but are very well worth doing and that I strongly support.
And that is where we are right now. We're in the negotiation stage in the physical infrastructure. The Republicans and Democrats are negotiating together right now to see if they can come to a compromise or if the Democrats will have to pass it through the reconciliation process. Remember, the Senate parliamentarian has ruled that they can use two more reconciliation processes this fiscal year alone, which is up until October, to pass two more packages. If they have to pass them both through reconciliation, I personally think it'd be a lot smarter to combine them and then pass them as one, only using one reconciliation process and then saving basically another one for a month or two down the road. But Senate Majority Leader already has, Chuck Schumer already has some tricks up his sleeve where he says there's a provision in the law that says you can go back and amend reconciliation bills to add additional items such as stimulus checks or any of the other stimulus package provisions that we talk about on this channel. They can actually go back and edit them. So there's kind of an unlimited number of times that they could possibly do that as long as they get the support within their own Democratic team to do that. And that is where the other negotiations are going on right now for the stimulus package. The American Families Plan is really just negotiating between the Democratic team, even as you've seen Chris Coons say there at the end that that bill likely won't get Republican support. He kind of said it in a roundabout way, but it's a 99% chance, I would say, 99-1 odds if I was at Vegas, that there's no way they're going to pass that with Republican support, the American Families Plan, the stimulus part of it, where they want the stimulus checks in there and they want the Social Security increase, they want the free college, and they want the increase of the child tax credits for more years that pays out these those monthly stimulus checks to children and their parents. 99% chance that won't pass with Republican support. So really all they need to do is negotiate that between the Democrats themselves and say, okay, what do we want to put in there? How much do we want them to be? Do we want a forced stimulus check in there? How much do we want it to be? We have almost 100 Democrats already pushing for monthly recurring stimulus checks for the forced stimulus check. That's separate than the child tax credits, which are already monthly stimulus checks. We're just talking about a broader fourth stimulus check that everybody that qualifies for the previous stimulus checks would likely get this fourth round as well. And we already have a lot of support pushing for that from the Democratic side. And it's really starting to heat up now that they're actively negotiating what will be in this next infrastructure and stimulus package. So I will keep you up to date with all these different items and provisions that will be in the next stimulus package. If you haven't yet, subscribe down below, click the subscribe button, and join our family of subscribers. It's completely free to do so. This way you won't miss out on new upcoming episodes, which is every day at 10 a.m., 3 p.m., 8 p.m., and 11 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Don't miss an episode because we cover different items in different videos. You can click this top video here to watch my newest stimulus check video next. And this video teaches you how to start your own business selling products on the Amazon FBA platform. Me and my wife sell products on Amazon FBA, and we also teach people how to do that and replace their 9-to-5 income. So click on one of those videos next. Thanks, guys, and I will see you in the next video.